Dear students, now we'll start the topic of superposition of waves, and the very first thing we'll study is principle of superposition. You must understand that two or more waves superpose on a medium particle, and this is called superposition of waves at that point. Like if there are two sources S1 and S2 which are oscillating independently and throwing out waves in independent directions, and say there is a medium particle P which will oscillate in the influence of the wave emitted from source S1 if it is alone oscillating, and it will oscillate in the influence of source S2 if it is alone oscillating. Say S1 is producing a simple harmonic wave of amplitude say A1 and S2 is producing a wave of amplitude A2. Then we can say if S2 is switched off under the influence of S1, P will execute SHM of amplitude A1, and its motion equation will be given by the simple harmonic wave equation governed by the source S1. Similarly, if S1 is switched off and only S2 is oscillating, then P will execute simple harmonic motion with amplitude A2, and its motion equation will be given by simple harmonic wave equation governed by the source S2. Now, if both the sources are switched on simultaneously, then at point P, both the waves will arrive and P will oscillate in altogether a different manner, or you can say the oscillations of P will be modified when it is oscillating under the influence of both the waves. We can say P is oscillating with say its displacement given as Y. Then we say if Y1 and Y2 are the even, we can write Y1 vector and Y2 vector as the two sources may produce displacements at point P in different directions. Y1 and Y2 are the displacements at point P due to waves from S1 and S2 independently. Then, according to principle of superposition, the resulting displacement of particle at P in influence of both waves is given as yp is equals to y1 vector plus y2 vector. Now, if oscillations are in same direction, that means the two sources are producing oscillations along the same line of motion, then we directly take yp is y1 plus y2, no need to take vector forms of displacements. In this section, majority of cases we are going to deal with such situations when a point where waves are superposing, its displacement will be simply given by the algebraic sum of displacement produced by the independent waves. Even if there are more than two waves superposing at a point, the relation can be expanded as yp is equals to y1 plus y2 plus and so on up to any number of waves. By using the superposition principle we have studied, let's see superposition of wave pulses in a string. We just talk about a situation when say there is a string in which there are two wave pulses having different amplitudes A1 and A2. These are traveling in opposite direction with the speed V, as we already studied that the wave speed depends on the medium. As being a single string, the two will move towards each other with the same speed. We can see this pulse is producing oscillations in the string particle of amplitude A1, actually half oscillations, because it is one half of just a complete wavelength. Similarly, the other string pulse is producing half oscillation in string particles of amplitude A2. See what will happen when the two pulses will superpose somewhere between the two. At the point of superposition, the two will produce a half oscillation having amplitude A1 plus A2. Because here the two pulses are superposing over each other. The first one is of amplitude A1, the second one is of amplitude A2. When these will superpose at the point of superposition, the wave amplitude increases to A1 plus A2, and then the waves will move forward as these are traveling. So we can say in this situation, finally, the wave pulses will be in this situation. Or we can say the pulses when these will cross over. We can say after crossing over each other, the wave pulses will travel as it is, as these were moving before. So we can say in this situation, a superposition will never affect the further propagation of waves. At the point of superposition, the oscillation of medium particles are modified, but before and after it will remain as it is. Similarly, we can see a situation when a wave pulse is above the string and another is below the string like this. See, if this is a pulse having amplitude A1 traveling with the speed V, another is having amplitude A2 traveling with the speed V. See what will happen when the two will superpose. The resulting pulse would be having relatively smaller amplitude, which is of amplitude A1 minus A2, because at the point of superposition, the upper pulse is having an amplitude A1 and the lower pulse is having an amplitude A2. So at this point where the two pulses will superpose on the medium particle, the resulting half oscillation amplitude will be A1 minus A2, as the two are in opposite direction. But certainly, after superposition, as the waves continue to propagate, we can state after oscillation, the situation would be like this. The pulses will move as it is without any change in their shape or their amplitude due to superposition. So we can say again, superposition never affects the further propagation of waves or pulses. This you can also keep in mind. We just write down a note over here that superposition never affects further propagation of waves.